Okay guys, today we're gonna do acidity and alkalinity experiment. Okay, the objective of this experiment is to determine the acidity and alkalinity of the water samples. For that, we need some apparatus such as burettes. We need burette stand. We need conical flask. We need water samples, and then we need sodium hydroxide, we need sulfuric acid, both with a normality of 0.02 N, and then we need methyl orange, and we need phenolphthalein. We have prepared the water samples according to the manual. We have prepared it below 4.5, which is the initial pH of this water sample is 3.08 pH, where we take the water and we add sulfuric acid to it to reach to 3.08 pH. So first of all, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the measuring cylinder and we're gonna measure 50 ml of the water sample. Okay, and now I'm gonna transfer this water sample to the conical flask. After that, I'm gonna add 3 drops of methyl orange. After that, I'm gonna mix this methyl orange. As you can see, the color of the sample is now red. We going to titrate this sample using sodium hydroxide until this pink color sample or red color sample is going to change to yellow orange. So the initial volume of the sodium hydroxide that we are going to use is 37.2 ml. Okay, so now we're gonna start the titration process. When we do titration, we have to be very slow. We have to let the sodium hydroxide drop by drop so that we don't exceed the amount of hydroxide that we should get into the sample. As we titrate, we have to mix the water sample so that we can know does it change to yellow orange or not. As you can see, now the water sample has changed color from red to yellow orange. So we have finished our titration. Now we can take the reading for our used sodium hydroxide. So we have used about we have used about 50 ml minus 5.4. So the final reading of the volume in the burette is 34.6. So there's another experiment for acidity. We're gonna measure again 50 ml of the water sample. I'm gonna transfer it to the conical flask. Now we're gonna add 3 drops of phenolphthalein. give it a mix, and now we're gonna titrate back again using sodium hydroxide until this water sample change from colorless to pink. Again, we have to titrate it very slow, drop by drop. As we titrate, we have to mix the sample so that we can know is it changing color. So we have to titrate until it reaches or it becomes pink color. Okay, so now you can see it has changed to pink color. Okay, now we're gonna take the final reading again. So now the final reading is 31.8 ml. So now we're gonna do an alkalinity experiment. For that, I've prepared this water sample. I take water sample and I add sodium hydroxide so that the pH of the water sample is above 8.3 pH, and this sample's initial pH is 11.56. So again, I'm going to measure 50 ml of water sample. And then I'm going to transfer it to the conical flask. And now I'm going to add phenethylene 3 drops. Give it a mix. And I'm going to titrate this sample using sulfuric acid until it becomes colorless. As we titrate, we have to mix a sample so it completely mixed. As you can see now the sample have changed to colorless, and we take our reading again. So the reading, the final volume of sulfuric acid we used is 31.4 ml. Using the same titrated sample, we're gonna add 3 drops of methyl orange again. Mix the sample, and we're gonna further titrate the sample until it changes from yellow orange to red using the same sulfuric acid. And the initial reading now is 31.4, and we later take the final reading. So now the color have changed from yellow orange to red, and we take our final reading, which is 28.1 ml.